knows all about this. He loves going to exotic places like Cuba. I mean, and Michael is heading for Havana as well. Amazing the places that we go. He said, I want you to think about, where are you in transit to? Right now, November 2017, where are you going? What does it look like? What are you looking forward to? What's joyous about where you are right now? Because, you know, stuff happens. In a 90-day period, I had four surprising events happen to me. The first one was, I was hit by a taxi as I was crossing the road to go into the airport. Very inconvenient. Second, I was volunteering at the primary school and my wallet got stolen. Very inconvenient. I was on a tour travelling between Russia, across Europe towards London, but in Russia, my whole pallet load of resources went missing. Very inconvenient. And fourthly, I came home and my young son fell out of the front of a motorboat and was run over by the motor. It was a tough 90 days. You ever had that feeling when things just aren't rolling the way you want them to? And I've learned this about my life, that life very much is about how I respond to the adversity that comes my way. Because whenever I take an adventure, stuff happens. Really great stuff and really scary stuff. Things that capture your heart and things that sometimes make you despair. And I'm just wondering right now, what's adversity? What role is it playing in your life? What's happening in your life that really is shaping who you are and the messages that you will be bringing for the coming years? Because that's really important. Is that no matter what our expertise is, you know, there's a good chance that people are going to be more educated than us. They're going to have more degrees, more doctorates, more experience. But what makes us so needed on the platform, delivering keynotes? What is it that actually will put you in front of people for the next 30 years? Will it be your successes, or will it be the way you respond to the adversities in your life? It's an interesting question, isn't it? Now, I'm familiar with adversity, because I was born with my left eye permanently closed. It's sort of no great handicap in comparison to my children. But for me, I can still remember growing up with the names that kids call me. They started to do plastic surgery on me at age 2. They just started to stitch open the eye so I wouldn't lose my sight. And then by the time I got to school, it was half opened. Kids are really creative when it comes to name calling. They came up with about 100 cruel names. And the two that I heard nearly every single day were, Lisa, you are so ugly. And you look dumb. And how old was I? I was 5. Where do kids get this stuff? I can still remember running home to my mother, throwing myself into my mother's arms and saying, it's not fair. It is not fair. Ever said it's not fair? Something in your life not fair? My beautiful mother, who's a 13th child raised by a grandmother, who knew all about life not being fair, just pulled me really close, grabbed my little face, pulled me right up to her eyes. She said, sweetheart, life's not fair. I said, is that it? She said, no. She said, if you don't like it, don't do it to others. I said, Mum, that's not fair. She said, correct. What's not fair in your life? What's not fair for you? What is it that you dwell upon and you stay in that space that you don't think you can shift out of because life's not fair? It's sort of funny looking back now because I start to feel like the thing that appeared to be the breaking of my little world was actually the making of me as a woman. Because I had to learn how to talk to me. I mean, the kids would call me dumb and ugly, but more important was, what did I say to me? And I learned this. The most powerful words that you're ever going to hear in your whole life are not the words you hear from other people. Not the audience, let me tell you. Not the client. But the words you say to yourself, about yourself. They're the words that will shape your future. And be interesting just to have a little recording of all the things that you've spoken about yourself over the last 7 days. What have you said? How have you responded? And how do you speak to others when they're not speaking well of you? So what's the conversation that just rolls out of you? And is it worth bottling? Is it worth keeping? Like, do you really believe that words matter? Is it possible that everything that we say is either building us up or tearing us down? Either drawing people closer to us or pushing people away? Maybe shaping the self-image of our children or just squeezing the life out of them. Or inviting people to come into your world because there's something nice about just hanging out with you. What could you be saying differently about yourself? What's the key words that you describe yourself by? Not the words on your brochure. Not the words that Brett says about you. What are the words that you say about you on a daily basis? And would your best friends agree? Would your partner agree? Would your children agree? I mean, you just have to ask my children, describe your mother. It's frightening. Because, you know, I've got a 23-year-old and she knows everything. And I have a 25-year-old who is far too big and tough to argue with. And I have a 34-year-old that has two little babies that just needs all the nurturing and support that she can get right now. But the words are the thing that I get paid for, and yet the words are the stuff that builds my life. What are the key words building you for this year? What are you going to say about yourself all year? What are you going to say about the way you do life, the way you do business, the way you interact with your partner? I can still remember my parents saying, Lisa, you should say you're lovely. Oh, but there's no way I could believe I was lovely because I was the ugly girl. So they said, go to the nearest possible word. I went, oh, lovable. I'm lovable. Look, my parents tell me I'm lovable. You've got to find something, and then you've got to build on it. Where are we going with those words? So I want you to turn to the person next to you, and I want you to tell them three words that you think describe a little bit about you. Come on, just three words.